My name is Kristen Jellison, and I'm an assistant professor here in the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering at Lehigh. My research focuses on waterborne disease, and in particular looking at one pathogen, which is Cryptosporidium. It's a parasite in drinking water that makes people very sick. It causes a gastrointestinal disorder. There's no medical cure for it, and our current methods of water treatment are not 100% effective at killing the organism. So my lab looks at ways to understand better the way the organism moves through the environment and different environmental conditions that impact its survival so that we can figure out how to protect drinking water sources from being contaminated. One of the major problems in the world is the lack of adequate supply of clean drinking water for people in a wide range of communities, from very rural communities in developing countries that don't have any sort of infrastructure to people in very developed and urbanized areas such as New York City or Philadelphia. So I think that most people, when they think about water quality problems or water supply problems, they really think about that as something foreign, something that happens in the developing world where people don't have any infrastructure, and they don't tend to associate that with more developed countries, particularly the United States. And in fact, the biggest outbreak of cryptosporidiosis happened in 1993 in Milwaukee. And this was a result of people just drinking water from their tap. And the water treatment processes at the time were not effective at inactivating this organism. And as a result, 400,000 people were infected with the organism. Close to 100 people died. Most of those people were immunocompromised. And that's because there's just no medical cure for it. What my lab tries to do is to address these issues on a range of, different projects. Wissahickon Creek serves as one of the water supplies for the city of Philadelphia. And they know that there's cryptosporidium there. They're not exactly sure where it's coming from. It could be coming from agriculture, it could be coming from wildlife, it could be coming from humans. They don't know what the most important sources are. And they want to try to determine that so that they can develop watershed management. So they send us samples twice a month. We analyze the samples, look for cryptosporidium, and if it's there, we extract the DNA and sequence it, and are able to look at the sequence and identify what the major source grouping is. So the Philadelphia Water Department is going to take the information that we give them and use that to really target the important sources in the watershed. We're also looking at what is it in the environment that impacts cryptosporidium fate and transport. Are certain watersheds more susceptible to having live and infectious oocysts? Are there certain watersheds where the oocysts are likely to be killed or inactivated very quickly? And maybe we don't need to be as concerned about those. And so in my lab, we're looking at the effects of solar UV radiation. We're looking at how solar UV might act as an inactivator of cryptosporidium. We're looking at certain zooplankton species, little animals that live in water supplies, how they might graze on cryptosporidium and actually eat them, maybe remove them from the water column. And we're looking at how biofilms, which are very sticky surfaces, you might see them on rocks in the bottom of a stream, but a biofilm is really anywhere where bacteria have colonized and sort of grown, and they form very sticky surfaces, how biofilms might impact cryptosporidium fate and transport. The biofilm might trap cryptosporidium and actually remove them from the water column. They might protect them from some of these environmental conditions, from the UV, from grazers, from interactions with other environmental parameters that might inactivate them. So we're looking at how biofilms could impact cryptosporidium fate and transport as well.